as us bow our hearts to hear a word from the Lord. See your word. Our world is in trouble. Our leadership is in trouble. Our country is in trouble. God, you are the special prosecutor. You're the just judge. And as we pray, we still pray for the safety of the president. Travel around this world. Protect him and his family. Cover him with your gracious blood. But God, we still ask for justice.
Hallelujah.
Righteousness exalts a nation. We thank you, God, and we depend on righteousness. Now bless these your people everywhere. Those that are sharing with us on Facebook Live and YouTube and Roku. Minister to somebody. And those that gather here in the temple. Let them hear what the Spirit has to say to the church. We realize today that we need you now. More than ever. Honor us and keep us. Bless the saints. Most of all now, God, as your word go forth, change somebody's mind. That they may come asking, Lord, what must I do to be saved? Bring them into the kingdom for such a time as this. Hallelujah. Save life. Reach that person that may be somewhere watching us in a desperate situation. Reach them. Minister to them. Somebody convalescing. Minister to them. Minister to their family. God, somebody in rehab or incarcerated that may be watching us tonight or today. Minister to them. In the name of Jesus, honor everybody, those that are in the valley of decision. Hallelujah. Give them the divine direction. Show them the right way to go. Now honor the saints. Honor the people of God everywhere. For this is your servant's apostolic prayer. In Jesus' name, let the people of the Lord put their hands together and shout to Jesus. In Jesus' name. There is a word from the Lord. And it's in the book called Hebrews. Hebrews chapter number two. We shall commence reading at verse number 10 through 13. I was going to start at verse 12, but I think I'll go to verse 10 through 13. The word of the Lord emphatically declares, for it became him for whom are all things, and by whom are all things. Let's go back. For it became him, listen to the significant language of the text, for whom are all things, and by whom are all things, in bringing many sons unto glory, to make the captains of their salvation perfect through suffering. 11th verse. For both he that sanctifieth and they who are sanctified are all of one. For which cause he is not ashamed to call them brethren. I want you to hang your hat on the 12th and 13th verse. Say, I will declare thy name unto my brother in the midst, watch this, of the church. Will I sing praises unto thee.
Wow.
Again and again, I will put my trust in him. And again, behold, I am the children which God hath given me, and all the people said.
Amen.
I am the children that God has given me. I am the children. I want to talk to you about the responsibility of the position.
All right.
We talked about the management of the position.
Great, sir.
I want to talk to you today about the responsibility of the position.
Oh, yes.
It is very, very important as kingdom citizens that you understand that where you are in the kingdom of God, in terms of your appointment in the kingdom, you have a responsibility to generations after you.
That's right.
Yes.
What condition would the church be in when your children, are in charge?
Well, my.
Well, that's good.
When your child
is
in charge. Well, you can't blame the child, good, bad, or indifferent.
Right now.
If you're going to blame, it has to be on the generation that brought that child
up. All right.
I don't want to bash the children because I don't blame the children. I blame my mom and my daddy for me preaching today.
Right. Well,
is their fault that I'm a gospel preacher?
Right.
Is their fault?
That's right.
I'm saved.
Right.
Sanctified.
Right.
Filled with Holy
Ghost. Talk to us. Right.
Is my mama and my daddy's fault?
That's right.
That I love to go to church.
That's right.
Is their fault that I get up here saying, thinking I sound like Luther Vandross? Is their fault? Is their fault that I play the organ down at the church?
All right.
Is their fault?
Is their fault
that I love Jesus?
Yes, sir.
That's
like
right.
I love.
That's right.
Yeah. Why you say it's their fault? Well, from a baby to a man.
Uh-huh.
They made sure
yes.
I went to church.
Wow. Yes.
They didn't just make sure I knew Jesus.
Uh-huh.
They made sure that I had an appreciation of the people of God who gathered in the house of God.
Yes.
They made sure that I was socially sound.
Yes.
I knew how to operate in a social setting.
Yes.
It's their fault.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
That I get calls to preach conferences around the world.
Talk, sir.
It's my mama and daddy's fault.
All right, now.
That I am the first vice presiding bishop of International Bible. It's their fault.
Yes.
That I am the bishop over the Caribbean.
Yes.
And get high respect in Trinidad, Jamaica, Grenada.
Yes.
It's their fault.
It's their fault.
That people send me plane tickets and fly me around the world. And I see the world, not because I'm wealthy or rich, but because of what's in my mouth.
Right. Yes, sir. Yes.
Great.
It's their fault.
Yes. Yes.
They shouldn't have never told me that Jesus is the way.
Yes, sir. Yes.
The truth.
Yes,
glory.
And the life.
Talk, sir.
I blame my ministerial success.
Yes.
On my mom.
Wow.
And my sanctified.
Yes.
Opposite of that.
Uh-huh.
I'm going to leave it alone.
Well,
Do your children know Jesus?
Wow.
Come on.
We didn't get to tell mom and daddy we weren't going to church. And then when we got there, we had to act like we was happy with Christ.
Amen.
I saw only children choir.
Yes.
And I still remember the song, the very first song we saw on the children choir.
Jesus.
If I had a hammer,
yes, sir.
My Lord,
yes.
A hammer in the morning,
yes.
A hammer in the evening,
uh-huh.
All over this world.
Jesus.
I hammer out justice.
Yes.
I hammer out freedom.
Yes.
The love that we have between my brothers and my sisters.
Yes. Yes.
All
over
this world.
Yes.
I remember.
All right.
Yes, sir.
My mama fought. I had to move to Raleigh. And Mother Freeman, the old lady, had a little children choir.
Yes, sir.
Going on this children's choir. And my mama and daddy's therefore, they put us in Mother Freeman's children's choir.
Yes.
When we moved from Danville to the Sunshine Band.
Yes.
Huh? And I remember the first song we sung on the Sunshine Band, we're marching.
Yes, sir.
On the Zion.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Beautiful Zion. Marching up towards heaven.
Yes.
And therefore, now when your child gets grown, can they blame their mama and daddy?
Well, yes, Lord.
Come out with your
auntie.
Yes.
Uncle.
Yes, sir.
Grandma.
Talk to you, sir.
For telling me.
Yes.
Teaching me.
Yes, sir.
How to walk with God.
Yeah.
That's a beautiful testimony.
Yes,
yes, sir.
Yes.
That's a wonderful testimony.
Yeah.
When I, great Sunday school teacher standing, I remember my first Sunday school teacher, Sister Velma DeShazer. Sister Velma DeShazer. I couldn't say her last name then, I can't say it. But I remember getting up early Sunday morning.
Wow.
How did we wake up on Sunday morning? Mama fixing Annette and Cynthia's hair with that hot comb.
All right.
We woke up out of the smell of hair.
Yeah.
She got that hot comb. Y'all remember that?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
The new ones don't know that, they go natural. They put water on it just like that. They good.
Come on, Bishop.
And they're the world.
Come on, Bishop.
My mama used to take that hot comb off the stove.
Yes.
Put some gold crown on it.
Yes.
Take that hot comb and that heat. Be flying. And while she was going straight in that hair, she blowing.
Church, Kevin, but we had to participate.
That's right.
Yeah. Say that.
Because they had a responsibility to the generation after them.
Yes.
Wow.
Anybody here?
Yes.
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 It's a good thing.
It's a good thing.
When somebody take time to make you.
Yes.
Yes.
David blamed God.
Uh-huh.
When he said, he maketh me.
Yes.
Yes.
David blamed God, didn't he?
Yes, sir.
Amen.
I feel like preaching.
Preach. Preach.
Can I?
Preach.
Shall I?
Preach.
Must I?
Preach.
Think I'm going to preach.
Preach.
David blamed God.
Yes, sir. Yes.
He made me to lie down.
Yes.
That's
in green pasture.
Uh-huh.
Don't do that, you're going to make me preach. Free. He leaded me.
Yes,
besides,
still
war.
Yes.
And guess what? He restored my soul. You know what that means? Yes. When I got to cutting up, he restored me. When I got indifferent,
yes, sir.
Didn't want to,
yes, sir.
Have your mama and daddy ever restored your soul?
Yes.
You called it and got a whooping.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. You on track.
Yes.
Yes.
And right through here, tiny little children need some restoring.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
And can't nobody restore you.
Right.
Your daddy was all right, but can't nobody restore your soul. The original state of man is crowned in glory
and honor. I wish I had two. The original state of man was to have dominion over everything in the earth. The original state.
The original.
A man is that you can tell the animals to go hither, come thither. You have the authority over the earth. You can sow what you want to sow, grow and subdue the earth.
Yeah.
That's your original state. But what happened is man tend to only focus on the fall of man.
Wow.
Anytime we talk about the creativeness of God, we immediately, once we talk about it, we talk about the fall of Adam.
Amen.
We talk about Eve and Adam and deceiving, but you never spend any time talking about, wait a minute, before any of that happened, I was crowned with glory and honor.
Yes.
God gave me dominion.
Yes.
So now I have a choice in the earth. Watch out. I got a choice in the earth whether to pay more attention on my failures or on my victory.
Yes,
when you first came in here, you came in here victorious. When you first came in here, you came in here with power, honor. You came here with glory. Glory is the manifestation of the presence and the splendor of God. You first came in here to carry out the revealed will of God. God's purpose and will for you was you to carry out the vision of God in the earth.
Yes, sir.
And everything that was blessed, everything that was righteous, everything that was pure came through you. Everything that was godly came through you. But now we so focused on our failure. We talk about, I'm just a man like you, a man.
Come on, sir.
You know stuff happens and stuff happens. And you know I can't help myself. If I could, I would. You living under your failure.
Come on.
You try to please God and let folk accept failure. Make folk accept I can't see it, seeing I'm just seeing. And seeing you, everybody's seeing it. See, the devil is a lie.
Yes.
You just don't know the sin question. You can't answer the sin question. The Bible said if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. All things are passed away. Come in here. That all things, and all things mean all things. Don't you try to make all things mean something. All things become new. You don't have to be a failure. Gird up the Lord of your mind and be sober. You don't have to let nobody get in your ear and make you feel lesser than what God gave to you. Look at your neighbor and say, I'm proud with glory and honor. Less than that.
Hallelujah.
You're not going to make me accept that I'm less than that.
Yes.
Y'all are not, women, you are not letting no man make you think you less than that. Man, you are not letting no woman make you feel less than that.
That's right.
They call us all kind of stuff, thugs and the N-word. They don't say they use the N-word. Then let me leave it alone. Because it's easy for them to say the N-word now than to say the word.
Yeah.
So if you say N-word, you're calling me a Jesus, I don't accept that either.
Amen.
That's why they changed you from Negro to color.
Yeah.
From color to black.
Talk.
Black to African American. I want to know why everybody else stay the same.
All right.
Because they're moving us any kind of way they want to. I'm tired of being moved. When whoever brought you in this world don't know who they are.
Well,
come on,
hallelujah.
You ought to know who you are so you can tell who you brought up in here,
come
who
on.
They are.
Come on.
If you still searching for your life, why are you praying somebody up in here? You ought to know that I'm a child of God. So that means anything that comes from my Lord, they are sons of God. Verse
both he that sanctified and they who are sanctified are all of one.
You can't make me feel less than I am.
All right, man.
Amen.
Call me stupid. I ain't got to be stupid because you call me stupid.
Amen. That's right.
That's right.
That's right.
That's right.
It ain't what you call me that matters.
Amen.
It's what I answer to that.
That's often right.
If somebody call you some woman of God and you turn and respond to that, It only becomes that when you respond to it.
Amen.
I'll never forget, I went to the Justice Academy in North Carolina, Salemburg, when I was working for the prison system. We had people from all over the country, all over the state, brother. And I walked past these two gentlemen, they were white, drinking Bud Light. And as I walked, they said, "Don't kick over my Bud Light, nigga." That's all right. Yeah, I kept walking.
That's right.
I went on where I was going.
That's right.
They weren't talking to me.
That's right.
They were talking to each other.
That's right.
I wasn't drinking no Bud Light.
Right.
Them two niggas were drinking Bud Light. I'm just making a point. I ain't using the word because they're going to go to you. I'm making a point.
Right.
You ain't got to respond to what you're not. Yeah. Woman, if you ain't going to be, why you turn around and say, "I know you didn't call me"? No, I'm not what you call me. Unless my name Betty, Brenda, Barbara, Bianca.
Man, preach like you want to.
Then you get in the church. I'm going to move on. Excuse me for using that illustration. I'm sorry. But my point is, you get in the church now, folk counted around. You ain't no bishop, you're an elder. You're not an elder, you're a minister. I'm a prophet now, so I don't. I'm the head of the missionaries, I'm over the ushers. And I'm over, no, you're the chief servant. That means you're the one that's been called out to do what nobody else will do.
Yeah.
It's not for you to stand under some kind of pseudo authority.
Yeah.
To make people feel less of you. What you are saying is follow me. As I follow Christ.
Yeah.
I'm your example of how this thing ought to be.
Yes,
just so the glory of God.
Yes,
I'm about to go, God. So the glory of God can feel the love of God. Use me, Lord.
Preach.
Use me for your glory. Use me, Lord. Help me to tell the story. If I can be the example of someone. The way I walk, let somebody watch me.
Talk.
The way I talk, let somebody watch
me.
The way I live, let somebody watch me. If I can't be like Jesus, I'll be like the Jesus in you. Tell your neighbor, say, "Neighbor, until I can be like Jesus, can I be like the Jesus in you?" Come on, baby. It's gonna be alright. You got to pull on them because I don't want you.
right. Can I just ask you? But I want you to know, Jesus, it's all right for you to do what you do. But until then, just know I told you about Jesus. Don't forget you can call your mama. And when you call your mama, she's going to pray for me. Don't forget you can call your daddy. But when you call your daddy, he will say, son, I told you how to talk to God. I told you how to pray. You're a man now. You need to know how to pray for yourself. I wish I had a witness. Tell your neighbor, say, neighbor, we are all of God. We are heirs and joint heirs. Hallelujah. Whatever Jesus is, I am just a closer walk with thee. Credit Jesus is my plea.
that I can say thank you when you're not. Those of you who want to take your time, thank you. I pray for you.
Yes.
That God will honor you.
Yes.
This is my prayer. This is what I'm talking to you.
Yes.
Yes.
Hallelujah.